Welcome everyone to Latinx Now. I'm Christian Acosta.
And I'm Nastassja Bolivar.
And I am Claudia Vergara.
All right, another crazy week in Hollywood, another show here at Latinx Now. All right, before anything else, please remember you can watch us en español on Telemundo every Saturday at midnight.
Yay.
So yeah, now you have a date on the weekends, right?
And then you learn Spanish with us, guys.
It's true, yeah, for those that don't. All right, but you know, let's jump right into the headlines because, of course, we've got a lot to talk about. Demi Lovato has quit Twitter after she received backlash for reposting a 21 Savage meme following his detainment at the hands of ICE, which is, of course, Immigration and Customs Enforcement. Claudia sat down with rising star Yalitza Aparicio to talk about all of her newfound fame. And, man, it was a busy week for Claudia. She also interviewed the funniest, spiciest Colombiana in the game, the incredible, man, we love her, Sofia Vergara. Oh, and did we mention that Sofia is her tia? Yeah.
Rhymes. That's creepy.
That's why you guys have the same last name.
Sofia is her tia.
That's it. I basically could join Migos. I'm that good at rapping, right? Stop. All right, guys, but you know what? Let's start off talking about Demi Lovato because she's created a storm, a social media storm, when she posted a Twitter message where she was referring to the Super Bowl being boring.
But the problem was the way she put it, okay? Because it started a chaos. What she wrote was, so far, 21 Savage memes have been my favorite part of the Super Bowl.
All right, yes. Yeah. So yeah. That's incorporating now, you know, some controversy because here's the backstory. 21 Savage has been detained by ICE earlier in the morning and accused of overstaying his visa since he is a British national, which, quite frankly, a lot of people didn't even know that you know, he's a British national,
we
right?
Didn't know.
Did you guys know?
You know how I found out?
It was what?
Through Latinx Now social media. I'm there.
I did too. Like,
what do you mean?
I'm looking at it and then I'm like, wait. Hold on.
Link in bio.
What? Link in bio. Go in, read the whole story on Latinx Now. Now, I'm not putting this as an ad, guys. This is not an ad.
Or maybe
it is. But I had no idea he was from the UK.
No, not at all.
No one knew. That's why it was funny because I was like, who would have thought?
Right. Yeah. So a lot of people started posting memes and funny comments and all of that. You know, sort of laughing at the situation. But look, at the end of the day, we're talking about a possible deportation. Yeah. It's a very serious matter. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people are taking it seriously. Yeah. Like, for example, Offset did respond to Demi's tweet. And he's like, hey, you know what? This is what he said. He replied with, all the memes ain't funny when somebody going through it, and it ain't funny, his family depending on him. So basically saying, you know what? This isn't funny, and his family depends on him to work, and you're here laughing at it? Not cool.
He wasn't the only one also that tweeted back. There were several tweets from everybody, but there was one in particular that did spark more, and it was from Wale. Wale ended up replying back to Demi as well, and he wrote, why is somebody freedom funny? I don't get the joke. And that's when Demi ends up replying back, and she's like, Wale's just salty. I never replied to his desperate tweets years ago. And then this is when Raleigh replies back, guys. Sorry, I know this is like a whole little chat.
No, but this is the story.
But this is when it gets good. Yes. This is when it gets good because then Raleigh replies super classy and he writes, still ain't gonna disrespect you. Still praying for you, Demi. Glad you see my old tweets. Hopefully you've seen the ones providing comfort and prayer when you were down. I don't kick people when they down. Go queen.
And then that's it. No further
comments.
And
then what does
she do? Deleted her account.
She deleted her account. That's when she was like, his mic drop, and she was like, no, yeah, I have
to say. Of course, so you know what? Of course, this all begs the question, you know, is it unfair, all these nasty comments about her tweet, you know, or should she be getting this type of backlash, right? And look, I actually want to speak about this first because the truth is, right, we do have mixed feelings. She's the first one to say, hey, you know what? People have been talking nasty about me. It's not cool. And she's actually done that in the past. So much so she's gone off social media because of people making fun of her.
Yeah, this isn't her first social media.
And here she is making fun of somebody's serious situation, right? Look, I got to admit, I laughed. Like, there was a couple funny ones that I laughed, right? But at the end of the day, again, it's a deportation. I'm not publicly saying, hey, this is funny and this is the only, besides the Super Bowl. It was just not the right thing to do. It's not cool.
Yeah, maybe she wasn't thinking about the deportation when she did it. Like, I understand. It's not, I don't agree fully, but I understand because maybe she wasn't really thinking about that part of, like, the serious issue. Yeah. She was just like, oh my God, who would have known that he was British?
Yeah.
LOL.
No, I do agree. I remember just first and foremost agreeing with the part that the Super Bowl, to me, and I'm not a big Super Bowl person, but it was a little boring.
It was boring.
It was boring. I didn't see that much
action. I would never see that. I would never.
But exactly, we just watch it for the halftime in the commercials whatever. Yeah. But when I see that he's on Latinx Now, that he's British, I was like, oh, what? I would have never. But then her writing this, this is where it goes sour. It goes south because of the immigration, because he is getting deported, because he is being detached from his family. You guys, 21 Savage is basically from ATL. Like, he has his family raised there. His business started in
Atlanta.
He's been
there for years.
He's been there for years. Mm-hmm. And it sucks, especially like us. Like, I was born in Miami, but I still consider myself 100% Nicaraguan or 100% Colombian. So I'll always be attached to them. But for somebody to say, hey, Nas, you're not from, like, Nicaragua, I get hurt. So I'm sure he probably feels the same way when we're like, you're not from Atlanta. You're probably from the UK.
Right.
Go back home. And then you have somebody like Demi coming on here and saying, hey, you know what? I was laughing. That was my favorite part of the whole Super Bowl. It sucks because it's a very serious conversation.
Of course. No, absolutely. Especially since she's one to, you know, tell people to not throw stones. And then, you know, she's here throwing stones. I think she could have done a much classier move than say, hey, you know what? You're right. I apologize. I shouldn't have laughed at this. It is a serious issue. And then that's it. You know, like, let's move on and let's all learn from this. But this whole, like, let's shut down Twitter, she'll be back in a week.
Yeah, but you know what's, I think you said something that is definitely a key point, is accountability.
Accountability,
I think when
yes.
people take accountability, I think it does, you know, because we're human. We mess up, and it's okay to mess up. It's okay to meter la pata, like we say it in Spanish, you know? Sometimes you just put your foot in your mouth, and you say things you don't really mean, and you can come on and say, you know what, guys, I do apologize for it. I'm so sorry. I think running away from the situation is not a good look on her.
Yeah.
But then again, we also have to remember Demi Lovato and where she has been the past couple of months. Right. You know, she's still growing. She's dealing with internal issues. So I'm sure this is a lot for her. And I'm sure she probably got on Twitter and was like, hey, I want to reconnect with everybody and be laughing. And then...
No, and then I think she said it, was it on Instagram or Twitter? Whatever. That's what she said, like, this is why I don't tweet anymore.
Right.
Is it because of, like, the...
Yeah, she went on Instagram to say that.
Uh-huh, on Instagram. Mm-hmm.
You're right.
Which,
you're
in fact, she actually even called out Wale on Instagram because she then did write, like, an apology, like, saying, sorry, guys.
An
like,
apology-ish.
It was a little apology-ish.
Yeah.
It wasn't, like, full on, but she was like, I'm sorry that I can't say anything and, you know, be attacked for it. And Wale, if you have anything to say, you can DM me.
Well,
so it's still kind of, like, aggressive.
I just think, again, she's attacked other people for saying things in the past. So you know what? If you can give it, if you can dish it, then you learn how to take it. That's pretty much it. All right, guys. Another celebrity is in a messy situation as well, is Liam Neeson. Yes, Liam Neeson of all people. He's the subject of a controversy. You know, he admitted to seeking out violence with a, as his words, black man following the rape of his friend, you know, many, many years ago. He actually was at a press conference, you know, he's promoting his new movie, Cold Pursuit, and he was basically asked if he has any real life connections to the revenge topic.
How has he come about bringing that character of revenge?
Correct, correct. And his response, you know, was completely off key. And actually, this was his response.
Baffling.
He was basically saying how, you know, he was 40 years ago, that a friend of his was raped. And when he went to discuss it with his friend, that his immediate response was, okay, what color was this man? And she responded that, you know, he was a black man. And then after that he went on the hunt for a black man in my black neighborhood.
Yeah.
And I just, people have found this completely racist because it pretty much is.
Guys, I have so much to say and I'm not even sure if, listen, first and foremost, exactly what you were saying. He was asked about the topic of revenge. How does he find inspiration behind, you know, getting that character? And then he talked about many years ago, he had one friend that was raped and he was livid that when he came to ask her, the first thing that he asked was, what color was he? And to me, who am I to say if you're racist or not? I don't know, but did it sound racist to me? It did. And then in Good Morning America, he wanted to go and clarify because then that's when he got a whole bunch of boom of, I'm not racist, I'm not racist. But then he further went to explain and he said, I am not racist. I thought, okay. And after that, we were, there were some nights I went out deliberately into black areas in the city looking to be set upon so that I can unleash physical violence. I did it for, I'd say, maybe 4 or 5 times until I caught myself on, and it really shocked me, this primal urge I had. It shocked me and it hurt me.
Yeah. So he did clarify that he sought the help of a priest, you know, to sort of, I guess, calm this rage that he was feeling. But the bottom line is, he's almost more clarifying the story versus, I don't know, maybe apologizing for what he said. Look, I think here's the bottom line, right? Is that our words have power. Our words have strength, and they go very far, especially someone like Liam Neeson, who has fans all over the world. And just by immediately saying, I went on the hunt for a black man.
People will
hear that and will misconstrue it.
And then we'll
do a lot worse with that, right? So I think that we have to measure our words, realize what we're saying, and be a little bit more careful, right?
I think so too.
Listen, I think it's just so sensitive, guys. I think it's so sensitive because my mind, and again, I'm opinionating for myself. When I automatically, if I'm thinking, if I'm gonna ask you, you know, you're my friend that was raped, God forbid, but you know, hey, so are you okay? I wouldn't ask, what color is he? My first instinct would be like, okay, which way did he go? Where was it? Where were you at? What was he wearing? I guess skin wouldn't be thy first.
Again, it has strength in what he's saying.
Yeah,
the first thing that he's
especially
saying,
especially how
it's
he's
Liam
saying
Neeson
it.
And how he's saying it, right?
Not only that, but then you continue on Good Morning America saying that you went to black areas.
Shut up.
What is a black
hole? Here's the hole.
You're going to be taken. That's what's going to happen to you, Liam.
Yeah, so, you know, again, it's a major controversy. You know, from Liam Neeson, who's, you know, been pretty, you know, clean as far as controversy for
his career.
I was surprised.
So,
yeah, it was very surprising.
It was.
To show you that you got to be careful with your words. Yes, very much
so. That's the lesson of the day right now.
Of course, it is.
That's your lesson of the day, too.
Whether it's tweeting or whether it comes out of your mouth, just think about it.
All right, guys, and a big news story that's happening in the music world is that, yes, Piso 21 vocalist Jane is leaving the band. Yes, he posted a video message to announce it, you know, and he's obviously saying that he's going to move on to a solo career. So the question is, of course, will Jane make it as a soloist? Will the group continue to be as successful also without Jane? You know, he was an integral part of the group. So a lot of fans, a lot of Piso 21 fans are saying, what? No,
what?
How can this be? And, you know, it's a big turmoil. Like, a lot of people are sad about this.
Really?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm just...
A lot of people are, like, giving him a lot of support is what's happening. Everyone's like, we love you, and we wish you the best.
Well, he's got a ton of fans, of course.
I have to be honest.
What?
I guess I'm not really into...
Piso 21?
Yeah, I'm not.
Neither am I. I'm not a fan
I just don't... I don't even know... Oh, man, that's going to sound terrible. I'm sorry, guys. I really am.
Well,
but let's
you don't have to be fans of everyone.
I can think back on Destiny's Child. I can think back on NSYNC. I can think back on so many bands that...
Man, you're taking it way back. I thought you were going to talk about Fifth Harmony and One Direction.
We can talk about them, too. But my curly heart...
Menudo!
You guys, leave me alone! Leave my Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, and Destiny's Child era alone, okay? First and foremost, what I was gonna say is, can the group survive? They definitely can survive. I think Piso 21, from what I was reading before, they got a new member already too, right?
Yes, they've already announced a replacement, and you know, a lot of people are saying, no,
he's
it's
been
not
replaced.
The same.
They'll be fine.
What do you guys think, since you guys listen more than I do?
You know, I've known them for many, many years, and they're hugely successful around the world, despite maybe you two
I've
not
heard
listening.
Of them, don't
right,
get me
of
wrong.
Course.
Yeah, yeah, no.
And you know, it's interesting because a lot of people, of course, you know, maybe did focus on Johnny a little bit more than the rest of them.
See, it's a typical way it goes in these stories,
right,
always.
Right, of course. So now this is his opportunity to go out. And, you know, one of Johnny's closest friends is J Balvin, and they support each other a lot on social
media.
Can I
ask you something?
So that's a big move for Johnny.
I know you've been in the boy band and the singing and that whole... Do you think the others feel type of way when one leaves, like Yanni leaving? Do you think they're hurt by it?
Oh, for sure. Now, of course, publicly, they're all saying it's wonderful. Like in the past, as you said, Beyonce, when she left Destiny's Child, you know, there was also a lot of, well, will Beyonce be a success or not? But we've seen the massive success of Beyonce after leaving Destiny's Child, like you had mentioned, for sure. I mean, come on, Destiny's Child, who? Sorry, it's Beyonce.
I still jam to Destiny's Child,
but I
don't
know.
But nothing compared
done.
To Beyonce's career as a soloist. Nothing.
I mean, absolutely not, but you can't compare Destiny's Child with, you know, with Beyonce either. Like, that's too different. I don't know.
All right. I'll take that.
The same way how you can see with Camila Cabello and Fifth Harmony. Like, I like Camila Cabello and her solo, but you also think about Fifth Harmony and their music.
I like both too.
Okay, but you're going to tell me that Camila's success...
But Destiny's Child is not the same at all.
But it don't exist anymore, Beyonce. Obviously. But
exactly, that's why. You just said it.
But I definitely think Camila's been a bigger act as a solo artist than Fifth Harmony is as a group, for sure.
Yeah. Guys, let me tell you, what I'm trying to say is when they were a band, I was still a fan, and now that they're going solo, I'm going
to
be a fan.
She clings to her past fan.
I'm a loyal girl.
You're loyal. I like that.
I was going to say that.
But you know what? We had Zayn with One Direction as well, but okay. All right. We have many examples of that. So anyways, good luck to Jane and to Piso 21, because, you know, we of course want them all to succeed. And another thing, you know, that we all know for sure is Ricky Martin's career. Yeah, began with Manuel.
You're right. Yes. It reminds me of my mom. Mom used to play Menudo for me all the time.
Is that right?
Yeah, she was like a super fan.
Yes, well, you know what? We got big news that, of course, Ricky Martin will be performing at the Grammys.
Woo!
Yeah, so that's major, major news. And it's just fantastic because, of course, we're getting that representation on there at the show as well.
What a year Queen for Ricky. Kidding? Ricky hasn't stopped from his babies to then Gianni Versace to now performing at the Grammys. Guys, I'm excited for this Grammy. When is it? Are we going to be there? No, but we will be there for the after show, guys.
We will.
Sunday.
Yes, Domingo.
Sure. Yes, absolutely.
Anyways, by the way, guys, also, Camila Cabello is going to be making her Grammy performance debut as well because she received 2 nominations for Best Pop Solo Performance for Havana and Best Pop Vocal Album for Camila.
How many does Fifth Harmony have?
Stop. Okay, that's my question.
I'm just saying.
But what I'm saying, where did Camila come out of? Though?
I'm just saying. Stop. Right.
Jesus.
You know?
Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, you know who else was nominated? Who? Cardi.
My girl!
Yeah, she is your girl, definitely.
Yes.
She was nominated for I Like It, right?
Yes.
DJ Bobbin and Bad Bunny. It was for Album of the Year.
Woo!
Major. Yeah. Album of the Year for Invasion of Privacy, and with I Like It was Record of the Year.
You guys, I think that's probably my Album of the Year.
But you know what? That's not it. She also had a Best Pop Group Duo with the Maroon 5 song, Girls Like You, and Best Rap Performance, Be Careful, and again, Best Rap Album, and Invasion of Privacy. I mean, it's like, I can continue on and on. It goes on and on for Cardi B.
I love Invasion of Privacy the same way I love Shawn Mendes, because he's also taking the Grammy stage for the first time, you guys, and is nominated for Song of the Year, In My Blood, and Best Pop Vocal Album, Shawn Mendes. I think Shawn Mendes has really grown up in our eyes. Like, I remember seeing him like a Bieber before, and then now, like,
Excuse
he's
me?
Like a man. No, Bieber's yours, don't worry, I'm not getting involved with your man. But Shawn Mendes.
No, don't compare him.
No, but Shawn Mendes is someone that will be around forever, I think. Like, he's one of those real artists. Yes, yes. All right, but you know what? There's also a lot more Latinx amongst nominated for sure. We have La Voz coach Carlos Vives is nominated for Best Latin Pop Album called Vives.
Wow, didn't know.
Yes, for Vives. Luis Miguel is also, he's nominated for Best Regional Mexican Music Album titled Mexico Por Siempre. I love that name.
And then we also have Angela Aguilar is nominated for Best Regional Mexican Music Album for Primero, soy mexicana. I have to say it like that.
Yes, Angela is increíble. I mean, she's so, so talented.
You know,
incredible voice.
I can only imagine, because I haven't listened too much into like the Mexican regional music.
Her voice is out of this world.
Really?
I interviewed her years ago, and I was just like,
amazing. Wow. How old is she?
She's super young.
She's super young.
Wow. Yeah, she's making us look bad for sure.
Making you look bad.
And then Natalia Lafourcade is also nominated for Best Latin Pop Album for Musas Volume 2.
Natalia is also one.
Natalia, when she releases her stuff, that's it. She gets it. Like, she is it. She's a
real music artist. I love her when I was like 15.
She's incredible.
When I was in school, I remember her. There was a song called like Un Pato. Do you remember about that song?
No.
How did it go?
I remember.
We'll have to jam to it. But all right, guys, Alicia Keys will be hosting the 61st Annual Grammy Awards for the first time in a career that has earned her 15 of the prestigious gold gramophones.
Just 15?
So that's massive for Alicia Keys. Talk about doing everything, right?
Also
musical artist and now hosting. All right, guys, up next, we have Oscar frontrunner Yalitza Aparicio. I can't believe that we got her. Skyrocketing to fame, and Latinx Now snagged an interview with the rising star.
And it's a family affair because Claudia interviews her aunt, the mega famous Sofia Vergara.
Mm-hmm. Stick around because we will be back.
Sofia and Yalitza, that's insane.
Right back.
Sofia and Yalitza,
seriously,
that is
you guys.
Welcome back, Latinxers. Yalitza Aparicio is an Oscar darling in the making due to her riveting performance in Roma. It's superb and she's superb in it.
Yeah.
And Latinx Now got the chance to chat with her.
Claudia had the chance to chat with her.
All right, Claudia got the chance to chat with her all about her newfound fame.
Yeah, it's a disaster. Guys, despite all the Oscar buzz, she still manages to be super humble and super sweet, and needless to say, she has our heart.
Yes.
You got it, Yalitza.
I sat with her this weekend, a few hours before she attended the Directors Guild Awards, where they got for more recognition, so.
That's fancy.
Can we watch this? I'm really excited.
I'm obsessed. I'm obsessed. I can't. Bueno, Yalitza, primero que todo, muchísimas gracias por tu tiempo. Gracias por estar en Latinx Now. La verdad que para mí es un honor estar acá contigo. No puedo la felicidad. Me parece que tu historia es impresionante, es increíble. Me inspira mucho a mí, así como sé que le inspiran muchas mujeres latinas. ¿Qué se siente? O sea, ¿tú alguna vez en la vida soñaste con esto?
No, yo no soñaba con vivir toda esta experiencia tan increíble. Se veía como un mundo tan lejano, donde no encontrabas a alguien que se pareciera a ti, donde tal vez tus posibilidades económicas no te permitían llegar.
Vi que estabas en Vanity Fair, vi que estabas en Vogue México. Una de ellas decía que nacía una estrella. ¿Tú te sientes como una estrella?
Me siento extraña, eso no cabe duda. Cada vez que volteo a ver todas esas revistas es increíble, porque verme ahí y decir, ¿cómo es posible que estoy ahí? ¿Qué pasó?
Sí,
a ver, ¿es en serio? Pero, no sé, muchas personas me dicen, ya eres una estrella, ya estás ahí.
Es que sí eres, estás diciendo que sí eres.
Y luego me dicen, es increíble que, aunque no lo hayas soñado, estás ahí, nos estás motivando, estás haciendo cosas que a nosotros nos hace reflexionar y decir si se puede. Entonces creo que sí soy una estrella.
Sí, eres una estrella.
She's a massive star. For me, she's a massive star.
I was more nervous than she was. It was like if she was interviewing me.
Yes?
Like, I was like, it's such an honor to be here with you today.
Is she as peaceful as she was in that interview?
She has like an aura. Like when she speaks, you're like,
it's calming. It's so nice, right?
It's soothing.
I gotta say, when I see her succeeding, and it's like, I feel something.
You're like, you deserve it. You go, right?
I feel like I'm succeeding with her.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's weird. It's really awesome.
It's just she deserves it. Yes. Like some just she's.
Everything happens for a reason. If she's there, it's because life and God, or whatever you believe
destiny,
in.
Destiny, the universe.
Things, like she deserves it.
Yes, all right, but you know what? That's not it for the interview. This is just an excerpt of it. We will show you more of it in the coming shows as we approach Oscars night. So there's more to come with Yalitza.
Claudia, what else did she tell you? Like, did she mention about Nastassja, probably?
All right, guys. Coming up, it's a family affair. No? Claudia interviews her aunt, the mega famous Sofia Vergara.
Yeah, all she did was called me as she does per usual. So,
don't miss it, guys. Latinx Now. We'll be back with so much more.
All right, guys, you know that here on set, we basically have a modern family of our own. And speaking of the show Modern Family, you know we just found out yesterday.
Don't say it.
That the 11th season of the series will be its final one. Yes, its final one. It's coming to an end.
You guys, I'm having commitment issues this year. First Game of Thrones being done, now Modern Family. Please don't do it to me. Don't.
It's incredible, though, what this show has achieved and represented and all of that. It's fantastic. But we are going to miss it.
It really made you feel part of their family.
These 10 seasons have been incredible.
They're
so we have one more to
best.
Go, which has been fantastic. Yes.
You guys, literally, I got the pleasure, I guess, of interviewing my aunt. And let's just say the genes in her family are very strong.
The genes.
Sofia told me all about her upcoming denim collection. And right back to it took you a while. Jeans, I think jeans.
You get it?
Got it, because she has a new jean collection and the jeans are strong. Got it, Claudia. Got it.
Yo no sé exactamente qué esperar de esta entrevista, pero aquí estamos. Con mi tía. Ok, a lo que vinimos y primero lo primero. Cuéntame de tu colección de jeans.
Bueno, te puedo contar muchas cosas de la colección. Estoy súper emocionada, como ya tú sabes. Esto lo vengo planeando desde hace tiempo. Queríamos hacer una colección muy accesible a todas las mujeres, de todos los tamaños, así, voluptuosas como yo, flaquitiquiticas como tú. So now I'm going to show you the jeans, how they look on the models. Real, voluptuous, skinny, tall, and models of all sizes. So this beautiful girl is wearing the Sofia, which is the same jean I'm wearing right now.
Which this is the one I need.
Which I'm gonna give you this after we finish working. After I'll give them to you. So we have different washes. This one is a little bit more distressed. And then is this one, like the one that I'm wearing right now, which I love. You can wear this like for anything. So these jeans are the Paula. They're named after my cousin Paula Sofia. And she's a college girl, she's 18. And I thought these were perfect to name after her because, you know, it's the kind of jean that you can wear to sleep and to go to class. And you can be like in long flights. So I thought this is like a very young and comfortable option. This one is the Melissa. Mm-hmm. I named it after another one of my cousins, Melissa. She's very tall and she's very voluptuous, and she loves to wear jeans that have a flare because she thinks that they make her look longer and tighter. And so that's why I named after her, because
slimmer.
Slimmer, that's the word. Because this is what these jeans do. She's supermodel, she's wearing.
She can wear all of them.
She looks great in everything. And she's wearing the Rosa, which is named after another one of my cousins,
Rosa Marina.
And Rosa is very short, not like her. But Rosa loves white jeans and she likes to feel long. So I thought this was perfect for her because it's a jean that is like very straightforward and it just like hugs your body and looks amazing. I mean, look at her.
Stripes like that are really good because they're like,
We have it with the stripes and with no stripes too.
Okay.
And Claudia.
That's me.
She's one of my models also, and she's wearing the Claudia skirt.
For hours and hours and days.
For hours and days, and I think it's something that you can wear with tights also and make it a little bit more evening or in the winter. Or you can wear it like with high heels and like with her with the t-shirt. She looks great with anything. But I thought that this outfit was perfect for her.
Okay, so definitely want the Paulas. I definitely want the,
I need the
Veronicas.
And the Veronicas are my favorite.
And not for nothing, the Claudias are a really cute skirt. I like it too.
So thank you.
Sofia on the size 2.
Man, look at you trying to get some free swag here.
Oh my
Wait,
God.
Claudia, how does it feel to have like a skirt after you named after you?
I mean, it's sold out already.
Oh, oh man.
Not really. I'm lying, but it will.
All right, guys.
Huh. Have you ever been to a Modern Family set?
I have.
You have?
Many times. Don't be jealous.
And fun.
No, it's amazing.
Good.
They're all amazing.
It's like a,
they
it is a family,
so
right?
So nice. It is.
Yeah.
They are, and I mean, it's been 10 years, so.
Of course.
No, they are a family.
I feel like they spend more time together than with their own family.
Yeah, yeah. So. All right, guys, we'll be right back with more Sofia and Claudia Vergara Adventures. I could see a show just about that, right?
Oh, my God. Yeah.
And Claudia Adventures. All right, guys, stick around.
Can Nastassja be like?
No, not you. Welcome back to more Latinx Now.
And more family shenanigans with the Vergara girls.
Well,
that's like a new show.
I like that.
That's a new show.
You guys are like getting me excited, but okay. Enough about jeans, and we're about the Vergara jeans. You know what I mean? You see what I did there again? Okay. Let's just say I put my aunt to test. I don't know. Take a look.
No me gustan los juegos.
¿Qué?
Bueno, dale.
Pensé que me iba a regañar.
Dale.
Bueno, ¿de qué tanto me conoces tú a mí?
Ajá.
¿Okay? Yo solamente he sido fan de una persona en la vida.
Ay, de Justin Bieber.
Ok.
Yes.
¿Cómo le digo a Manolo?
Mongi.
¿Cuál es el cumpleaños de Baguette?
El cumpleaños de Baguette, ¿qué tiene que ver contigo el cumpleaños de Baguette? El cumpleaños de Baguette es diciembre 2.
¿Dos? Sí. ¡Ah!
¿Qué tiene que ver contigo?
Sí, es.
No eres la mamá de Baguette.
No, pero lo que quería preguntar, para si sabes. Bueno, ¿qué es mi go-to de ropa? O sea, ¿qué es lo que más me pongo? ¿Qué me regañas?
Tu jean es de Walmart.
Ahora sí, pero...
Lo que más te gusta, los jeans y camisa negra, que siempre te regaño porque siempre uniforme, está con un uniforme. Cuando uno tiene juventud y belleza, aproveche ahora que está joven. Ajá. Y póngase colores lindos, cosas sexy. No tiene que estar como una monja de negro todo el día.
Entonces, ¿cómo que me toca vivir a mí? No sé, cómo sentirme. Pero gracias por tu tiempo.
Black is sexy, though. Right?
Is it weird to interview like a family member? In this case, your aunt.
It is. It's like, right? I know all the things already, so I feel like asking things that I already know.
That's true. You know, it's crazy because I'm watching and I'm such a Sofia fan that I'm like, oh my God. And you're like, yeah, it's Sofia.
Yeah. I was here, like, what am I going to ask her? And we're like, I already know everything about her.
That's it, right?
Sorry, not sorry.
So tell me everything about her.
You know what? Next time, Nastassja or I get to interview. That's what it is.
We should do like the three of us.
Yes.
It would be so cheapy, cheapy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Sofia.
All right, guys, for sure. You know, also another thing that we want to remind you of is tonight is the premiere of Betty in New York.
That's right, guys. At 9 p.m., 8 Central. You know what? On what channel?
You know
Telemundo.
Telemundo.
Yes.
Telemundo.
This seriously looks like so much fun. Like, it just looks like it's going to be like you're having a good time watching it, right?
And she's so
fun. And also, we're working on something very special. We'll be live on Twitter next Sunday for a Grammy after show.
All the winners, mm-hmm. the music, the fashion, and all the things.
That's right, you guys. So Sunday, February 10th, after the Grammys, Latinx Now will be with you guys.
We have a date there, right?
Yes, El
Domingo.
Yes,
another date. All right, guys. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Latinx Now.
That's right. And also on Facebook, on facebook.com/LatinxNow.
Wow, is that it? I know. Yeah. I feel like we've got a lot more to discuss. But man, seriously, next time Sofia Vergara is it for sure with us, right?
All of
us.
Jeans.
All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. We'll catch you on the next Latinx Now.
Fit amazing.
Yeah?
You don't
if my booty looks like Sofia's and I want it to.
Wait, if she makes a men's line, it should be a Christian jean.
Okay.
Yes.
There will be.
Seriously.
I'll make sure.
Or just clean
Christian jean, Manolo jean.
Yes.
This is Latinx Now.
And if you like what you saw, hey, subscribe. You know the button, so
where?
Click
yeah,
it.
Yeah, the one
where?
Right here.
It's right here.
Or maybe.
Or maybe.
Where is it?